So it was really Thomas Nast that created the jolly Santa Claus that we know about. There was still one thing that was missing, though. Up until the late 1800s, even the early 1900s, whenever you would see a picture of Santa Claus, he was always dressed in black. Where's the red suit? In 1931, the Coca-Cola Corporation was in financial straits. Why? Because they just removed cocaine from their product and sales were slumping. They put in caffeine, but it just wasn't the same. You know what I mean? Yeah? So they needed some sort of clever advertising campaign that would give Coca-Cola a pick-me-up. So they hired a very famous Swedish commercial artist by the name of Hayden Sundblom to create a Coke-drinking Santa. Okay, Sundblom modeled his Santa on his friend Lou Prentice, who was chosen for being overweight, cheerful, and he had a chubby red face. The corporation, however, insisted that Santa's fur-trimmed suit be bright Coca-Cola red. And Santa was born, a blend of Christian crusader, pagan god, and commercial idol. And all the Santas that you have ever seen in your life are based on the drawings by this Swedish artist. They are the Coca-Cola Santa. That is the Santa that we know of today. Coca-Cola is also spread throughout Europe, but there's parts of Europe where there's still traditions about the old scary Santa in the black suit. It's only in America where the only Santas we've ever seen are, the red, cheery Coca-Cola Santas. Stepping back from Christmas, we're going to proceed to New Year shortly, stepping back from Christmas, let's just understand what the holiday is so that we can celebrate it properly. Okay? Point number one. Christmas has always been a holiday that was celebrated carelessly. And when I say carelessly, I mean carelessly in two ways. One is that the observance was literally careless, that it was a time when Roman courts were shut down and people did whatever they felt like doing. Two, it was careless insofar as it was brought into the Christian religion thoughtlessly. No one ever asked, what connection does this really have to Christianity? People said, it's fun, let's do it. Point number two. Officially, Christmas is the celebration, it's the commemoration, it's the day when we celebrate the birth of Jesus. That is, the God who came to earth once and for all to do away with Judaism. He announced that the Old Testament is null and void, that mitzvahs need no longer be kept, that the Jews have been abandoned because they're an evil, sinful people, and that now that they've been abandoned, there's a new chosen people, the Christians, and there's a new Bible, the New Testament. And the Jews have no business from now on ever observing their religion. Their religion is dead and gone. That is the meaning behind the celebration of December the 25th. That's the meaning that a Catholic would attach to it or a Protestant would attach to it. Point number three, Christmas is a lie. Jesus definitely was not born on December 25th. Even a Christian will tell you that. Point number four, historically, December the 25th is a day on which Jews have been shamed, tortured, and murdered. Point number five, many of the Christmas customs, including Christmas trees, mistletoe, Christmas presents, and Santa Claus, are just modern incarnations of the most depraved pagan rituals ever practiced on this planet. Often when I give this talk, people get angry with me. And they say, Kelman, cut it out. We just want to have fun. We don't need to know all of this stuff. We don't intend any of this. We're not celebrating Christmas because of what Christmas means. It's just a nice time when people get together with good cheer, and are nice to each other, and they give presents, and they celebrate, and it's fun, and you're ruining the whole thing. And I understand that sensibility. I understand why people feel that way. To people who feel that way, I would just ask the following question. There's a holiday which is not celebrated widely in America. It's only a very, very small population in America that celebrates April the 20th. There's a slightly larger German, Austrian, Polish population that celebrates that day. April the 20th is Hitler Day. It's the day on which Hitler was born, and it's celebrated by neo-Nazis around the world. Imagine that April the 20th became a more popular holiday, and slowly, as its historical roots were forgotten, it spread throughout popular culture. Imagine five generations from now, your great-great-great-grandchildren are getting all dressed up, and they're heading off to a Hitler Day celebration. And they're all going to go, and they have little dolls with a little mustache on it, and they wear these cute swastikas on their clothing, and they go, and people dress up in Auschwitz uniforms, they do all sorts of cute things like this, and they all get drunk, and they have a party, and they play nice music, and they give presents to each other, and it's good cheer, and it's really happy. If you could travel forward in time, five generations, and you saw your granddaughter, your grandson, going off to a Hitler Day party, is there anything that you would want to say to them? Is there any message you would have for them? with this metaphor in mind, you can decide exactly how you want to celebrate December 25th, which is a day when Holocaust-esque activities were always perpetrated. I'll leave the discussion of Christmas with a Christmas card. In 1941, there was a Christmas card that was sent to the entire German people. It was published in a very popular Christian newspaper called Der Stürmer. And it was actually written by the newspaper's editor, Julius Streicher. Streicher, in 1941, wrote in this Christmas card to the German people that there's a way that this traditionally December 25th was celebrated. And he encouraged Germans to return to this sort of celebration. And he wrote as follows. If one really wants to put an end to the continued prospering of this curse from heaven that is the Jewish blood, there's only one way to do it. To eradicate this people, this Satan's son, root and branch. Have a Merry Christmas.